Hey y'all, today we're gonna talk about a key part of tracking your WordPress website, and that is using the Google Tag Manager. I'm gonna show you how to configure your Tag Manager and put it onto your Elementor site. In my case, I'm using WooCommerce, but before we get into that, I'm just gonna really quickly explain why do you wanna use Google Tag Manager? So in a traditional setup, you would put your Google Analytics tag on each page and then it would call back with every page. But nowadays everybody has a tracking tag. So then you have a Google Ads tag, needs to be put on every page, Facebook Pixel, same thing, Pinterest, Twitter, TikTok, everybody has more code to put on there. And there's no real way in this setup where you can have the different networks or the tags calling the networks talk to one another. So that's where the Google Tag Manager comes in. So basically what it is more code, another JavaScript tag that you put on your site, and essentially similar to what you would have done with just the Google Analytics tag, it covers all the pages, but it acts as a middle layer. Now, when you read about it, or you might have heard the term data layer, that is what they're talking about, is a layer of data that is created by the JavaScript that is the Google Tag Manager. So now how our setup is going to work is a page is called, the Tag Manager is called, and we can set rules in the Tag Manager as to which one of these is sent, what data goes where. So it just gives us a lot more control without having to mess with the code directly as much. If any of what I just said there doesn't make sense, feel free to ask a question in the comments. I answer all of them, so I'll either make another video or I'll respond to you right there. So to get started, what you're gonna wanna do is just create a container. In this case, I'm using a website called Heavy Business. It's a website, so when you're going through the setup, make sure you're choosing the right type of container for your property. So you just go ahead, click in there. Brings you to an empty dashboard state. And the first thing you need to do is get the code that we're going to add to our Elementor template. So to do that, you click over to admin, and then you'll see the tab here for the container, which is install. And it brings up these two windows of code for us to take and put into our WordPress site. Both pieces of code are going to need to be put into our Elementor template. So I just have it open here in another tab. This is my WordPress site. You'll see I have Elementor installed. And if you just slide down the menu here, you have the custom code tab, which allows us to place code into the template without needing to directly edit the PHP and HTML. I'll go back to my Tag Manager view here. And I'm gonna copy, it says right here, paste this in the head of the page. So the head is prior to when the content being displayed is actually going to show. And I'm gonna go add new in my custom code thing. I like to give them somewhat descriptive names. So like head Google Tag Manager. And then I'm just gonna paste the code. And you'll see here you have a location where you can choose where it's going to insert it. In this case, it's already on the tag that we want it in, and the priority is set to 1. We need it to fire on every page to do its job here, being the middleman. So we're just going to go ahead and hit publish because everything's good. And it's going to ask me where do I want to display it. In this case, like we just touched on, we want it on every page so that it can call these other tags as needed. So I'm just going to leave it as entire site. Hit save. It's going to create that tag for me. And then I will go back to my Tag Manager and get the one you'll see here. This one needs to be after the opening body tag. So before the content loads, you want to call the Tag Manager so that you can set those cookies or send those events, whatever model you're using. Again, we're just going to add new code. It'll put us back through the same loop. We'll call it body Google Tag Manager, and then we're gonna choose the body start. Some tags will ask you to put it at the end, usually to collect data off the page, but in this case, we're gonna just go ahead and put it where they tell us to. Again, it's gonna ask where we wanna put it, and I'm just gonna leave it as the entire site and hit save. When I come to my custom code tab here, you can see them both. I can look at my site and nothing's really changed. If we look at the source code, which is Control U on your keyboard, if you want to have a little shortcut there, then you just Control F, find Google Tag Manager. There it is in the head. So it's getting dropped in the page there. Perfect. I've already created an account for my Google Analytics. You can do the same by going to analytics.google.com. Next thing on the list is to add the Google Analytics tag to the Google Tag Manager. So page will be called, the tag manager is called, Google Analytics will be called. All of the tags will be called. With the account set up, I'm gonna go ahead and create a property. So I just go ahead and hit add property, give it the name. I'm gonna call it all website data. And I'm gonna set it to my time zone and the currency that I wanna work in, which is the almighty US dollar. Now, before I hit next, I'm gonna go ahead and hit the show advanced options button. And it says here, create a universal analytics property. I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I've been working with Google Analytics for a long time and I'm still learning GA4. So I'm gonna actually set up both on this property so that I can learn and make videos kind of explaining as I go what is going on so that you guys can learn with me. You'll see it's already opted in to create both. That's perfect. We can add both in the tag manager. So then I'm gonna go ahead and hit next. I'm gonna fill in some stuff about my business. You decide how honest you wanna be about it. And then you hit create. That's pretty much it for that step. You'll see I have a measurement ID here. That is for my Google Analytics 4 tag. Down here it has tagging instructions. It says you can use the tag manager. You can read it or I can just show you. So I'm back in my tag manager here. We're gonna close out of that initial tag. It takes me back to my main listing. So I'll go back into the container and move it down a peg here to the tags tab. And now I'm going to need to add my Google Analytics 4 tag to my Google Tag Manager. Hey, I spent 20 years nerding out on this stuff, so if you want me to keep sharing all the things I learned the hard way, please hit the like and subscribe button so that I'm encouraged and my ego is fulfilled, so I'll keep making content. So I'm gonna put in a new tag. I'll call it GA4. So you click the tag configuration and it brings up all of the built-in ones. So in this case, we can just take GA4 configuration and go back over here, take our measurement ID, copy it, paste it in there. We want to send a page view event when this configuration loads. Fields to set at this point, we don't need to set any. We just want to set the tag up to actually fire. And then we will trigger it on all pages because we want to measure our website. I'm gonna go ahead and hit save, and there it is. My GA4 tag has been configured. So as I mentioned, Google is in between data models. It tells you that in the instructions. So as of me making this video, I'm gonna set up both so that I can still see stats I understand while I learn the new system. So when you choose to create both in the signup process, it creates multiple properties. So one's tag GA4, you can go into the other one. And basically what we need to do now is add our universal analytics tag as well, just so that in my case, if you're new to this, maybe you only need GA4. In my case, I want a year of the stats because I've been doing this a long time and I know where everything is already. But I will be learning GA4, so if there's specific things that you would like to learn about that, put it in the comments and we'll learn together. The tags for your universal analytics setup are right here in the admin tab inside of the profile that we just selected. Now you just click tracking info, tracking code, and then it will give you a global site tag. Now the global site tag, it's a different data model, like I said, gonna do other videos about that. So we're gonna go back over here and just create a new tag. tag configuration. This time I'm going to choose Universal Analytics. I want it on the page view, as we said before, tracking every page. And the setting here, it's going to ask me to use a variable. Now, variables are great because you can manage a staging server versus a live server and just change the value of the variable. Since this is a simple setup, we don't necessarily need that, but you never know. So I will put it in a variable here. Now, they're asking for the tracking ID. Easy enough to get. You can just grab it right here or right here, paste it in there, auto. There's all these settings that you may want to. If you have advertising on your site, it lets you do things like remarketing, demographics reporting, stuff like that. I usually turn it on because I like to run paid ads. Content groupings, not a need right now. E-commerce, I'm going to turn on enhanced e-commerce features, and we will use the data layer to do that. And then I'm just going to rename it GA Universal Analytics and hit save. My Universal Analytics tag is configured, so now I just need to choose when it is triggered. So we have tags and we have triggers. Triggers are things that happen. Tags are things that are called to send info somewhere. Basically, that's the backbone of the Google Tag Manager you should keep in mind at all times. To go over this real quick, we have page views with our variable set with our tracking ID for our Universal Analytics property, all pages, hit save. Now I have my GA Universal Analytics and my GA4. Both will be called by the Google Tag Manager. So this question mark box could be Universal Analytics in this case. So page is called. Tag manager goes, hey, you guys, get in on this, sends the code to the page. The next thing I'm going to want to do is test that it's working. So I'm going to use this preview function here and put in my website. When I hit connect, it's going to open a specific browser with the tag assistant in the corner. Now, there is also a Chrome extension for the Tag Assistant that you can use that makes this way easier. Or you can check the data layer in the console if you're a nerd. So now that this is connected, what's kind of interesting about it is below, you hit continue and it's showing you what tags were fired. And on the left-hand side, you have some info about what's happened in that window. So if I bring it back up here, click into my hat, when I go back down here, you can see the calls are being made. It's telling me both of these tags have fired. There's no errors. You can see what was pushed to the data layer. So overall, you can say it's working. So you just go ahead, close that out. Yes, I would like to stop debugging. It will save your workspace for you so you don't have to type it in again next time. So we can close that window and it brings us back into our tag manager. The last thing to do is to hit submit. What it gives you next is a version control window. So I'm gonna call this tag manager launch. If you're in a bigger organization, you might want to agree on a naming convention for these because otherwise it can get messy if you have many contributors. In this case, it's just me. So you could put a description in there. Once you have multiple tags, the description window is quite helpful because you can say, I took this out, I changed this value, this wasn't firing. It gives you kind of a mental reminder of what happened, but then you're ready to do the next step. The final step, publish. Hit the publish button, sing like no one's listening, and boom, there it is. Two tags, six variables, all live, full history. We did it. It's that easy. Again, if you have questions, put them in the comments. I will do my best to help you or point you to something that can help. But otherwise, thanks for watching. Subscribe, thumbs up, all of that jazz. And I got more stuff I want to share, so stay tuned.